Hi, Hookies and Jam friends! We're going to start a new series called The Patriarchs, God's Plan Unfolds, and we're going all the way back to Genesis. Do you understand what this says? I bet some people can read it while others can't. Why not? Because it's written in another language. It says, pass the brick in Korean. Perhaps you've heard people talking to each other and had no idea what they were saying. Have you ever wondered, why don't we all speak the same language? That would make life a lot simpler. The Bible answers that question for us. Today, we're going to learn to give glory to God. God wanted people to fill the earth by having families. When God created the earth and everything in it, His first commandment to Adam and Eve was for them to have children and fill the earth. God loved His new creation, and His plan was for the earth to be filled with people who would know Him, love Him, and live for Him. Unfortunately, as the number of people grew, the people became more and more evil. The sin of Adam and Eve passed down to all mankind, causing them to do evil continually. God saw their evil and judged the people. He looked at their sin and knew they were guilty, so He rightfully punished them. God sent a great flood all over the earth. Nevertheless, God did save one man and his family from the flood, which was Noah. After Noah and his family came out of the ark, God told them to again fill the earth with children and continue to have families. God hadn't changed His mind about His plan. Now, the whole earth had one language and the same words. After the flood, people all spoke one language. God told them to spread throughout the earth, but they disobeyed Him. The people chose to stay together to rebuild a great city and to show how great and powerful they were. They said to each other, "Let's build a great city with a gigantic tower. It will stand on earth and reach to heaven. This way we can all stay together and we will not be scattered all over the earth." The people were feeling proud and confident in themselves and wanted everyone to know how important they were. They should have been bringing glory to God instead. Giving glory to God means to live in a way that shows how wonderful and important God is. However, the people continue to go their own way, working harder to build a tower. Higher and higher it rose. They were so proud of how the tower reached toward heaven. They thought this power, the tower, would make them great. But God saw that what the people were doing. He had created people to know and achieve great things, but they were using their God-given creativity and intelligence to do what they wanted, not what God wanted. They were disobeying God on purpose. I mean, let me tell you, building towers or being creative, it's not wrong or it's not sinful, but what's wrong is that people were pridefully choosing their own way instead of bringing glory to God. God had told them to spread throughout the earth, but they chose to disobey Him because of their pride. The people were about to learn how important it was to bring glory to Him instead of themselves, because God went down and confused their language. To show that God was in control, God caused the people to speak many different languages. They could no longer understand one another. Imagine how confusing that would be for the people. Because God had confused their language, the people left the city and the tower without finishing it. The city where the unfinished tower stood became known as Babel, or Babel means confusion. The people moved to all different parts of the earth. Those who spoke one language moved to one part of the earth, while others moved somewhere else. God's plan to fill the earth never changed because God never changes. Because the people spread to lands far away, the earth was now filled with people in many lands speaking many different languages. The true story of the Tower of Babel not only tells us where the languages of the world come from, but it also tells us how important it is to do things for God's glory and not our own. So the next time you achieve something great, go ahead and feel proud of yourself, give yourself a pat on the shoulder, two thumbs up, and treat yourself to some delicious donuts. But also remember to give thanks and give glory to God.